Minnesotans work hard for their money and want to ensure that it's spent wisely. But according to the shopping website wisebread.com, there are 10 items that you should avoid buying at your local grocery store. These are items that you're almost always going to be overpaying for. We have Ellen McNamara here with us now. And Ellen, you brought some of these items. We have them laid out, and you're going to kind of go through and show us how it is we can be saving some money.
Right, absolutely. I mean, you're a new mom. You know that laundry detergent, diapers, batteries for toys.
Yes,
they can definitely run up your bill a lot. And, you know, the average American family of four spends between $610 and about $1,200 a month on groceries. If your family buys the 10 items on this list on a regular basis at a smaller store, you can expect to pay a bigger bill.
Before you check out, check your options. Diapers, cereal, canned goods, magazines, laundry detergent, batteries, greeting cards, pre-cut food, cosmetics, and light bulbs all make the list.
Those are things that I try to buy elsewhere.
Sarah Carlson and Bree Borntraker are on a mission to save. They started the Real Housewives of Minnesota blog.
My ultimate goal is just to make our money stretch as far as it can.
We wanted to see how they stretch their money, so we went shopping and compared prices. A 14-ounce box of Cheerios was $3.99 at a local store.
So you paid $4 for one of them, where this one is about $5.50 for over double.
At Costco, where you pay a yearly membership, two 14-ounce boxes cost $5.49.
When you multiply the pennies over the course of a year, you're going to more than make up your membership.
If your family doesn't mind eating crispy oats, all these 14-ounce boxes cost $1.69.
By only carrying all the exclusive brands, we don't have to pay the marketing and advertising fees that are associated with national brands.
To the diaper aisle, Borntraker, who will deliver any day, is already mom to toddler Lydia and says you should only buy in bulk. 42 diapers cost $10.99 at a local store, or 26 cents a diaper.
I completely overpaid.
You way overpaid for diapers.
At Costco, you get 210 diapers for $31.49, or 14 cents a diaper. Buying online through Amazon is also an option. Unless there's a sale, canned goods usually cost more.
When I said $1.53 for one can, what do you think? What's your opinion of that?
So $1.53, I would say, is definitely overpaying.
Besides prices, the women say shoppers need to compare price per ounce. They use a cell phone to punch in a few numbers.
So there you're paying about 11 cents.
But if you buy 12 cans, you would pay 5 cents an ounce. If you buy those 12 singles, it's more than $8 you're losing. To save on laundry detergent, Carlson actually makes hers.
It costs us about $20 to make, and it makes for over a year's worth of laundry detergent.
Professor Anupama Pasricha says there's a reason this list exists.
The profit margin is fairly low in the food section.
It's a game of balance.
They would be making 50%, 70% on things like diapers, batteries, and things like that.
And because convenience is king, customers in a rush will overpay. But the two savvy shoppers say by knowing how to play the game, anyone can save.
I can save for college. We can save for vacation.
All right, thanks so much.
And here's the rest of our list. We have batteries down there. Batteries, cosmetics, and light bulbs, you're going to be overpaying for packaging. And the store knows that they have a longer shelf life. If you buy more than 3 magazines a year, you just need to buy the subscription. Some of them can cost about $5.
Yep.
Any prepackaged food items, you're going to be paying for your convenience and the store's labor. Then as for greeting cards right here, plan ahead. You can find them as cheap as 50 cents if you don't wait until the last second. And then, Leah, if you do ever see a sale happening at your local grocery store, that's the time that you need to stock up.
And these women don't really use coupons, right?
No, they don't. They say that sometimes couponing takes a little bit too long, and so they would just like to do kind of what they're doing. Mm-hmm. They shop at a number of different stores, find the best deals. They're not opposed to clipping coupons necessarily.
It's a matter of time.
But again, it's a matter of time. Yeah.
You're right, and that's really what it comes down to. Ellen, thanks. You know, if you want to see more ways that you can save on some of these other items that we couldn't get to, you can go to our homepage at kstp.com. You'll find much more there. Ellen, thanks. Here's another easy way to save, folks. Stop wasting the food that you're already buying. An average American family tosses out 14 pounds of food every week. That is 730 pounds of food per family each year. That's according to the National Resources Defense Council. And one way to avoid tossing out all that food is to learn the food lingo. Terms like sell by, use by, and best by, they don't mean toss out the food on that date necessarily. Sell by is the last date that you should buy something in the store, but it can still be eaten for several days, even up to a week after that sell by date. Use by is the date by which the item is considered top quality, but it too can be used for several days if it's stored properly.